What do you guys think?
How far will this be located from the Slant Redwood Airport?
I don't have those exact figures. We are required to file with the FAA. And it's a Form 7460. And they have to give us a ruling. Lots of governmental approvals to go through before we can ever start moving dirt or doing anything. So generally speaking, 200 feet is kind of the automatic number where if you're going to be 200 feet or taller, you're going to have airplane lights and all that. Anything less than 200 feet, this goes into a slope calculation, closest airport, closest helipads, hospital helipads, all those things get calculated in as long as those are registered with the FAA. Obviously, the FAA doesn't know about someone's private airstrip. They don't know about it or something like that. But knowing that the airstrip up there, northeast of Redmond, is known by the FAA, so that will all be calculated in. We don't know whether it will be required to have a strobe light that would be pointed upward, it would be pointing down any homes or anything like that, upward for airplanes. Worst case scenario, they would make us paint red and white, every 20 feet section red and 20 feet white. That is not believed to be the case because we don't believe that we are that close.
So you would get FAA certification?
Yes. And in fact, that could definitely be one of the conditions of approvals this evening is that we get the FAA approval. And we can provide that to you before we pull a building permit or whatever.
The nearest home?
I would guess it's down off the hill to the south. 2,000 feet, 2,200 feet, I would guess.
Water tanks in between them and the tower here?
Basically, yes. For your information, I'm also working on site in Gunnison. Which would help complete this area. Very good coverage, Salina, Redmond, and Gunnison. I'm headed to a city council meeting this evening in Gunnison.
What about south?
The only site that I'm working south is one for Panguish, but I'm not working all of the sites for Sevier. I just have my batch that I'm doing for my independent business.
One of the questions or concerns you have, and if we're going to issue a conditional use permit, what conditions are you put on that?
Well, we ought to have the FAA.
Right.
Yeah, certification.
Yeah, because we've been told we need to protect those airways, and there's a set of graduated overlay, you know, as farther you get away from the airstrip, the higher the thing can go.
Right.
And generally, anything over 30 feet is something to be concerned about.
I don't think that is in direct path of the airport.
I might even clarify that. The little they go in meters, but approximately 3.5 miles away, anything over 30 feet has to have FAA clearance. If it goes beyond 199 feet, that's usually it.
This 200 feet, yeah, that's kind of magical.
Okay, well, here's the deal. I know that airport is right. It's right on the border between our counties. So it's right here, and he's talking about a location, so we're about two sections away.
200. So it would be within five slopes from any direction.
And the FAA determination via the filing 7464 will let us know any requirements. And at worst case, they can come back and say, you cannot be taller than whatever height they calculate. Generally speaking, it's just a lighting issue and or a lighting and painting issue. They control that. They have their federally mandated glide slopes for how close, how tall. They can go through that calculation. And I'm certainly willing to accept that as a condition of approval that we have FAA certification.
Well, they're surrounded just nothing by hillside gravel, so there's no neighbors.
Except
hills.
Well, Neil, we lose this as on your property.
I don't understand.
Absolutely. In fact, I should have asked you to leave the room while we had this. We appreciate the information.
Okay, the road to this is through your property. The access is through your property.
And is there a road?
Yes.
Same road that accesses the water tanks? So it is an existing road, it won't be a new road.
There is existing telephone pedestal, telephone wiring up to the top up there. The sites are actually wired, meaning computers and all that in the cell sites are hardwired back to the switch. So we need telephone lines, and we also need electricity. The closest power pole is approximately 1,000 feet away on the same parcel. We will wait for the power company to determine which pole they want us to come off of, and we'll have to bring power in. We are proposed underground, I believe, based upon the ordinance that it's asking to come underground. But if the drawings were submitted, we're proposed to be underground for the power.
Dale, do you have any comments on this application?
No.
Hey.
If I would make a motion to accept this with a conditional use permit at underground balancers and...
But you need to submit...
And AFA.
But when that is submitted, then permit would be issued. Is that what you meant, Dale?
Yes.
Is there a second to that motion?
Could I request that that just be part of our submitting for a building permit and be reviewed that process so that the conditional use can be approved with those conditions?
What do you think?
I don't think he needs to come back and see us.
Well, he submits it to the clerk's office and then the conditional use permit is signed. That's usually how
it is. Okay, that's what we're going to do.
Is there a second to that motion, which was to require the underground power and the FAA approval before the conditional approval permit is signed?
Approval. Maybe we don't have to have the power, but just if that's what they're doing.
I'll second it.
Seconded by Carol. Okay, let's vote. Doug?
Yes.
Carol?
Yes.
And Kent?
Yes.
With Newell abstaining. So it is. It has been approved, and when you get that paperwork into the county clerk's office, they'll notify me and I'll come sign a conditional use permit.
Okay. And can I handle that all at the time that you submit for the building permit? In other words,
well, it used to be you could walk across the hall and do the building permit, but you'll have to go find her and give her the information, and she will get a conditional use permit signed, which means you'll have to call me to come do that.
Okay.
And then you can take it over to wherever the building inspector's office is. Isn't that there? You're at the Richland City Hall to get your building permit. But you can handle it in the same day, probably.
Great. We'll take care of that way. Appreciate your time and your help.
Thank you.
Thank you.